Governor holding a news briefing a short while ago with Mema and the State Department of Health. And now that they've set up a command center here on the grounds of the Ob Curtis Water Treatment Plant, the governor said that they've learned quite a bit about the problems here within this plant facility, now rushing in a pump that will be able to increase the outtake or output of this plant by another 4 million gallons. They hope to have the pump on grounds today and drop it into production tomorrow, but they've already found that this plant and the fuel water plant over by the waterworks curve was producing some 20 million gallons less than it was capable of doing. A lot of groundwork that needs to be done here as the state is marshaling a huge amount of bottled water, both potable and non-potable water, for residents to be using. I think it's 10 pallets on 18-wheelers loaded with pallets, I should say, bringing water in. They're going to have over 100 when all said and done as they marshal resources. The governor today expanding on what they believe the cause of this plant failure was, that it was in part playing a role with the flooding event that pushed so much water into the plant that needed more treatment. That slowed down the facility's ability to push water out. The 10 water tanks in the city of Jackson, they estimate all of them have at least half capacity, not nearly enough to do what needs to be done. And certainly when people are relying on that water for flushing and other uses, Jim Craig for the State Department of Health clarified that that water is safe to bathe with, but you don't want to do any bathing if you have an open cut. You don't want to let any of that water get into your mouth. If you're going to be using for any consumption, you need to boil that water for 3 minutes at least before you use any cooking or drinking capacity with that water. The bulk of the work, though, just getting started here on the state level. I asked the governor about a potential price tag for this type of work, whether it could be more than $30 to $50 million. He thought it would be more in that $30 million range, but they are just now getting boots on the ground and a hard assessment of the work that's going to take place here to get this plant back up and running. Live at the water treatment facility, Scott Sibbett, 16 WAPT News.